Hello. Jesus heals the blind beggar. Yeah. Jesus heals the blind beggar. The blind beggar is Bartimaeus. He receives his sight. So when they came to Jericho, as Jesus and his disciples, together with a large crowd, were leaving the city, a blind man, Bartimaeus, which means son of Timaeus, was sitting by the roadside begging. When he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to shout, "Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me." Many rebuked him and told him to be quiet, but he shouted all the more, "Son of David, have mercy on me." Jesus stopped and said, "Call him." So they called the blind man. "Cheer up, on your feet. He's calling you." Throwing his cloak aside, he jumped to his feet and came to Jesus. "What do you want me to do for you?" Jesus asked. The blind man said, "Rabbi, I want to see." "Go," said Jesus. "Your faith has healed you." Immediately, he received his sight and followed Jesus along the road. Yeah. So Jesus healed him. He healed Bartimaeus. Yeah, he healed him because his faith had made him whole. Yeah, that's something, huh? Yeah, so whatever you believe, whatever you think you need, you have to go to the one who can do it for you, who is God the Father in heaven. Yeah, you got to ask him. Even though he know already what you're thinking, what you want, he knew it before he formed you in the womb of your mother, you know? He already knows, but he just wants you to humble yourself and then come to him. You know, go to him and ask. Ask what you desire, you know? Tell him your heart's desires. Tell him what you're expecting. Tell him what you believe in him to do in your life. Yeah, what you're believing for. He just wants you to ask. In John 14:13, NIV, it says, "And I will do whatever you ask in my name, so the Father may be glorified in the Son." Yeah, so all he wants you to do is come and ask him. Ask him for what it is you desire, as long as it's in the will of God. You know, because in Numbers 23:19, New King James Version, it says, "God is not a man that he should lie, nor a son of man that he should repent. Has he said, and will he not do? Or has he spoken, and will he not make it good?" Yeah, in Matthew 7:7, ESV says, "Ask, and it will be given to you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and it will be opened to you." So you gotta ask, you gotta seek, you gotta knock, and expect for it to be open, you know? Because he'll give it to you, but he's not gonna just throw it out there at you. You have to seek, knock, and ask, you know? And the door will be open unto you. If you try just with your little effort, he'll finish the rest, as long as you initiate it. You know, Matthew 21:22, ESV, "And whatever you ask in prayer, you will receive if you have faith." Yeah. So whatever you ask in prayer, you will receive if you have faith, you know, but it can't be out of the will of God. It has to be in his will. Yeah, it has to be in his will. And you know, we don't receive things sometimes because some of us don't even ask. We're too proud. We won't ask. We won't humble ourselves and just ask God, you know? Humble yourself and ask him. "Father, I need this. Father, I need you to do this. Father, I'm believing for this. Father, I know you can do this, and I'm just coming to you, Father, humbly asking and believing by faith." In James 4:3, ESV, it says, You ask and you do not receive because you ask wrongly to spend it on your passions. Yeah, when God bless you, He want to bless you. He want to pour out a storehouse bank account blessing so you can put it up, you know, for missions, you know, so you could be a blessing to others with it, not just for you. He don't want you to just receive that blessing and have it just for you. It's so you could be a blessing to others, you know, to bless His kingdom here on earth as it is in heaven. Yeah, to be a blessing to the children here on earth, to people, you know, to help others. Not so He can bless you and then you can have plenty and then you just hoard it up and store it up for yourselves. No, that's not what God desires. That's not what He desires. He wants us to be a blessing to many, to help our sisters and brothers, you know, to help our neighbors, to be a blessing. Yeah. So Jesus healed the blind man, Bartimaeus. He received his sight. And they also have another one, y'all, about two blind men receiving their sight. It's in Matthew 20th chapter, 29 through 34 verses. Yeah. But I'm going to put it all in my description link. But this was a blessing to me, you know, because we have not because we ask not. And the blind man could have continued being blind. Bartimaeus, he could have continued to be blind. But he heard that Jesus was, he was coming. Yeah, Jesus was coming. And so he was bold enough to shout out. Yeah, he was bold enough to shout out, "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me." Yeah, then they tried to rebuke him, you know, and have him be quiet. You can't let people rebuke and make you quiet and shut you up, because you won't receive your blessings that way. You can do everything decent and in order. You don't have to be rude to them just because they're being rude to you. You know, he didn't worry about them. He just said it again. He got even louder. You know, "Son of David, have mercy on me." And then Jesus stopped and said, "Call him." So they called the blind man. "Cheer up, on your feet." Yeah, that's what they said. "He's calling you." They talking about Jesus is calling the man, you know. So that man, he threw off his cloak. He threw that cloak to the side. And he jumped up on his feet. Yeah, and he went to Jesus. And then Jesus asked him, "What do you want me to do for you?" Jesus asked him. The blind man said, "Rabbi, I want to see." Yeah, that man said, "I want to see." Bartimaeus said, "I want to see, Rabbi." So Jesus told him, "Go. Your faith has healed you." Immediately, he received his sight. Yeah. And he followed Jesus along the road. So y'all, I pray this was a blessing to y'all, because it was a blessing to me. And I just had to come on here and share it with you, you know, to help edify and build you up in the word, to help fan that flame of fire that's within you, you know, to just give you some hope. Because reading the word of God, it gives hope to all. You just got to spend time with them and receive it and believe it in your heart, you know. Yeah, so many blessings to you and your families. Check out my Ambassador for Christ YouTube channel. You'll receive videos and more words of encouragement, scriptures from the Lord. The Holy Spirit speak through me and I share them with y'all. I even do live videos at time when the Holy Spirit quicken my spirit to do so. I don't do too many of them because YouTube, they always mess up the lives. They always be, you know, they always start like buffering and it's just so much. So I just upload a video, record it, and just upload it. But many blessings to you and your family. Please click like, share, and subscribe on my YouTube channel to pass the word of God, this gospel, this good news on to many, many, many. Click like, share, and subscribe on my YouTube Ambassador for Christ channel. But thanks for checking out the podcast and many blessings to you and your families. Until the Lord quickens me again, my spirit again with something else, y'all have a blessed and wonderful day. And thank you for listening to Janelle's podcast, Ambassador for Christ.